The following video is a basic overview of the handheld scanner and barcode tracking app. Here you see the main desktop or main screen of the barcode scanner. Currently, we do not have the app open. To open the app, I simply double-click on the Pediatric Associates application icon on the desktop, just as I would a shortcut on my computer desktop, and this will cause the application to load. Once our application loads, we will be at the main screen of the application. This should show you your location name as well as your location code. And for this video's purpose, we're going to focus on the settings screen. Clicking on that link will bring us to that screen showing us the different settings. There's different tabs across the top, and the one we're most interested in is the last tab that says lookups. The service should list a capital P and a capital A, and we simply want to click the refresh button to refresh our lookup tables. What this will do is connect and download from our server a list of any updated items, barcode values, drug codes, etc. that will allow me to recognize barcodes when I'm scanning them. Once it's finished, I simply can click the X to go back to the main menu, and from here I can begin to use the app. A couple other quick things with the scanner. Down in the lower right hand corner, there is a virtual keyboard. Clicking on this and choosing keyboard will pop up a keyboard, allowing me to virtually enter information. This keyboard is very useful if you don't want to use the keys on the actual barcode scanner. To hide the keyboard, you simply click and choose Hide Input Panel. One note, when you are on a screen that has some prompts like this, when you click and show the keyboard, you'll notice my cursor goes away. After the keyboard displays, you'll just want to click in the field where you want to type, and then you can begin typing by clicking the keys on the virtual keyboard. If needed, you can also click and drag the keyboard to move it on the screen if it happens to be covering up an area where you would like to type information. And again, when you're done, simply click the keyboard icon, hide input panel, and you're good to go.